Yo, what up guys, STG, Sub the Gamer here. So right now I'm bringing you guys an online gameplay, the Nets versus the Phoenix Suns. Of course, I'm running with Deron Williams and the Nets, the definition of clutch. While I do so, I will be talking about NBA free agency for this year. This is probably my longest video on this channel, but you guys really seem to enjoy these long videos. So of course for you guys, I'm gonna try doing more of these. So I will be touching up on this gameplay because honestly, this is one of my favorite gameplays I've recorded so far. Just got this yesterday with a good friend of mine. But anyways, we're also going to be talking about these free agents. So we're going to be talking about the top 15 to top 16 free agents. We're going to be saving the best for last. But let's start off with Kirk Heinrich. So Kirk Heinrich played for the Chicago Bulls a little while ago. This year he played for the Atlanta Hawks. A lot of people know him from the Chicago Bulls. I'm from Chicago myself. I respect and love what Captain Kirk did at Chicago. He was their starting point guard even when Derrick Rose came. But when the Chicago Bulls were trying to pursue someone very big like LeBron James, they ended up trading Kirk Heinrich so they can get some more money. But anyways, in my opinion, I can honestly see, now that Derrick Rose is injured, I can honestly see the Chicago Bulls pursuing Kirk Heinrich. It would be a great thing for money. A lot of people would come back. They would love to see Kirk Heinrich. They would applaud him. We know how he plays. He knows how to play with Joakim Noah and all the Chicago Bulls players like Luol Deng. It would be a great fit for him, in my opinion. Next up, we have Brook Lopez from the New Jersey Nets, or should I say, the Brooklyn Nets. This guy was dealing with injuries for a long time this season, did not really get to play a lot, was very promising, but honestly did not get to play a lot. He was a really good scorer, but he could not get these rebounds, but I honestly see him staying in Brooklyn. Next up, we have Tim Duncan, arguably the greatest power forward of all time. There is no way he's leaving San Antonio. He's going to be staying there for the rest of his career, but honestly, these turnovers right here are killing me right now. I gotta think of something, and this just makes it worse. Shannon Brown just flew right there. Check out this amazing replay. Holy crap. That's Jordan right there. Well, a Jordan attempt at least. You can't beat Jordan. But anyways, now let's start talking about the free agents who honestly have a big chance of leaving their teams. The top 15, 16 free agents in my opinion this year. Let's start this off. So first up, we got Michael Beasley. Now this guy is easily capable of putting up 15 points a game, almost 20 points if he has to. This guy was a great player. He played for the Timberwolves this year, but honestly, there is no way he's staying in the Timberwolves with Derek Williams and Kevin Love. The Timberwolves just do not want him. He was even thinking of going to LA, but they got Ramon Sessions instead. I see Michael Beasley going to a team like the Kings, the Bucks, or possibly even Golden State. At number 14, we have OJ Mayo. Now, OJ Mayo was averaging about 17.5 points a game in the end of 2010. But of course, this season he did not play as well. But that doesn't mean he can't. OJ Mayo is a great scorer, plays in the clutch. He's a very young player as well. I can honestly see him going to a team that really needs a shooting guard. And honestly, the Chicago Bulls are one of the teams that really need a shooting guard. There are other teams that would really love a shooting guard. For example, the Cleveland Cavaliers. Now they have Kyrie Irving, great point guard, but if he can get that one shooting guard that can help him go, they can easily make the playoffs. So I see OJ Mayo going to a team, definitely leaving the Grizzlies, but going to a team that has and needs a shooting guard. Next up, we got Andre Miller. Now Andre Miller, in my opinion, is a very great point guard, proved it in game 7 against LA. He had very good games, and honestly, I see him going to a team that really needs a good point guard, and Marshawn Brooks right there with that clutch three. So Andre Miller, in my opinion, going to a team that needs a lot of veteranship. I don't think he's going to be staying in Denver. And right now, Steve Nash is killing me right now with that great pass. Channing Frye should have made that three. Thank God he didn't, but Steve Nash gets that rebound, and that really hurt me inside. Thank God he missed that first free throw, so at least I have a chance of coming back. I'm hoping he makes the second free throw, but what am I kidding? This is Steve Nash we're talking about, one of the greatest free throw shooting teams, players of all time. But the game is not over yet, guys. I called my timeout. Getting ready. I had so much confidence. The game before this, I got a game winner with Deron Williams. I wish I recorded it, but unfortunately I didn't, so there was no way I was not going to record my next game. But this is where clutch happens. Great crossover, 3-point dagger, 1-point game. This game is not over. This is the definition of clutch. We foul Steve Nash again. He's going to be taking these two free throws. We know what it is. He made his last free throw. He's definitely not going to miss another free throw. Steve Nash, one of the greatest free throw shooters in the clutch, proving it right now. I don't think I have any timeouts. And honestly, I take that back. I do have one timeout left. And I don't know who to take it with, but I make sure I go with a shooting lineup. A big time shooting lineup. Because I do put Brook Lopez as my center. Why? Because he can get those rebounds. I cannot trust Chris Humphries for this big rebound if I miss a shot. 14 seconds left to go. If I miss this three, game over. I need to make a three. I need someone who's clutch. And there's no one more clutch than Deron Williams, in my opinion. You've seen in my last long video, Deron Williams in the clutch. I felt like I was lagging right here. But it's all good, because D Will in the clutch for three. We going to overtime, guys. We're going to double overtime. But now let's start talking about these free agents, because we still have a lot more to talk about. So we got Chris Humphries right now. Now, Chris Humphries, in my opinion, he's going to be staying with the Brooklyn Nets. Honestly, he has a lot of hate. Not a lot of people support him right now after this Kim breakup. But he's a great player, in my opinion. He can get those rebounds. Awesome defense right here. But honestly, Chris Humphries is going to be staying with Brooklyn Nets with Brook Lopez, in my opinion. Next up, we got JaVale McGee. Now, JaVale McGee is known for being kind of a stupid player. No disrespect at all. Honestly, when I was watching the Denver Nuggets series, he was playing horribly in the first couple of games. A lot of Denver Nuggets fans were pissed. D-Will should have made this shot, but it's all good. It's all good. We're going to double overtime. But JaVale McGee seriously stepped it up in Game 6 and 7. He honestly showed that he's a great player. He did get a game winner this season with the Denver Nuggets. He's very young, too. In my opinion, with the help of George Karl, this guy is staying in Denver. Now we're going to be starting to heat up. Now we got Ray Allen right here. Great three-point shooter, arguably the greatest three-point shooter of all time. Now, Ray Allen, depending on if the Celtics win the finals this year, they're facing up against the Miami Heat right now, series tied 2-2. But if the Boston Celtics manage to win the finals, no doubt in my mind, Ray Allen will stay with the Boston Celtics going for a repeat. But honestly, if they lose, I have a big feeling that Ray Allen will finally end his career at a different team, a team that needs a shooting guard, the Clippers, the Bulls, team like that, the Kings. I can honestly see him going to one of these teams, and most likely a contending team like the Clippers or the Bulls. Next up, we got Nicholas Batum. With the absence of Brandon Roy, Nicholas Batum was playing so great. He's staying in Portland, guys. We're approaching our top five soon, but right now we got Eric Gordon. Eric Gordon is definitely staying in the Hornets now. Anthony Davis, first round pick. He's signing the papers. He's staying with the Hornets. Next up, we got Chauncey Billups. Now, this guy was injured for a lot of this season, missed all of the playoffs, but this guy has veteranship. He won a ring with Detroit, and I honestly see him going to a team that needs veteranship. The Chicago Bulls, the Brooklyn Nets, the Bobcats. I can also see him going to the Atlanta Hawks, possibly the New York Knicks with all their injuries they're facing. But now let's start talking about the top five, the main players. Let's start talking about Steve Nash first. Great point guard, arguably one of my favorite point guards of all time. He's such a beast in the clutch, clutch free throws, everything about this guy, so humble as well. I see this guy going to the Miami Heat. The Chicago Bulls are pursuing Steve Nash, and it's a big possibility that he can play alongside with Derrick Rose. But right now, a lot of people are saying that he's going to the Miami Heat. Miami Heat is my team for this guy right now. At number four, we have Roy Hibbert. This promising center, very young, in my opinion, will be staying with the Indiana Pacers. They will most likely have to give away one of their players, maybe David West, Paul George, Danny Granger, most likely not Danny Granger, but someone on their team, because right now their cap space is a little bit too high, and they got to give away someone. It is possible that Roy Hibbert might be able to leave, but honestly, I see him staying with the Pacers. Now we're approaching our top three. Number three, in my opinion, is Kevin Garnett. Look at this Steve Nash with that crazy step back shot. This guy is clutch. One of my favorite point guards of all time. But Kevin Garnett, one of the best power forwards of all time. Debatable with Tim Duncan. He is going to be staying with the Boston Celtics. Just like Tim Duncan is going to be staying with the San Antonio Spurs. Look at Deron Williams taking it to the rim. Great player, great game right now. 2-point game, 1 minute left to go. We're now approaching our top two free agents of the year 2012. Two more free agents left this year, and we got Andrew Bynum at number two. This guy had amazing stats this season. Remarkable season for Andrew Bynum, the 7-footer center. Yeah, but he was a very spectacle player. A lot of people loved him, but a lot of people did not like him as well. His attitude definitely was not the best. I don't think him and Kobe Bryant got along very well either. He started taking a little bit too many shots at the end. I know he should be taking a lot of shots, but some shots were very stupid and unnecessary. I see him leaving, possibly going to the Magic for Dwight Howard. But now, before we talking about the number one player, let's start talking about this gameplay. Gerald Green had an easy layup, two clutch rebounds left. I need a score. Do I go for the tie or do I go for the win? Deron Williams has been in the clutch for me this game, but there's one more player who's very clutch as well. This guy is a Kobe guy right here. Marshawn Brooks with the three for the win. Honestly, guys, I wish I recorded my live reaction. I got up two game winners in a row. I was screaming off my seats, but now we got one more player left to talk about, and of course, I'm saving him for last. He's the best point guard right now. Of course, one of the best point guards, Deron Williams. D-Will, my man, this clutch as heck player, I see him leaving the Brooklyn Nets unless the Brooklyn Nets can pull off something great in free agency. Deron Williams is from Dallas, so the number one contending team that he might be playing for is Dallas. A lot of people want him to go to Dallas. He would definitely not mind playing in Dallas with Dirk Nowitzki. Jason Kidd is getting very old, most likely going to be leaving. I honestly see Dallas for a perfect fit for Deron Williams. But of course, there's still a lot of Laker fans who would love to see Deron Williams playing with, of course, possibly Dwight Howard and Kobe Bryant. But my number one pick right now for Deron Williams is Dallas. But Brooklyn Nets is a big possibility for him. He did miss his game-winning three right here, my opponent. But Deron Williams, the number one free agent this year, I honestly see him leaving the Brooklyn Nets. He had a great season with the Brooklyn Nets. He put up a 58-point game. That just proves how well and how good he is, and honestly, see him playing for a contending team would be a great sight to see. But that's it for this gameplay, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. In the comments down below, please let me know who your top free agents are and where do you think they will be going. I will put a list down below in the comments, so please comment, rate, and subscribe. It takes 5 seconds and helps me out so much. Have a good one, guys.